हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ विशाल नाईक, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री, MPSC कॉलेज पनवेल. सो इन माई लास्ट वीडियो वी एक्चुअली डिस्कस ऑन IUPAC नॉमेनक्लेचर ऑफ अल्डिहाइड एंड कीटोन्स. इन टूडेज वीडियो वी डिस्कस द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर, दैट इज मेथड्स ऑफ प्रिपरेशन ऑफ अल्डिहाइड एंड कीटोन्स. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ वन मेथड दैट यूज फॉर प्रिपरेशन ऑफ डिफरेंट अल्डिहाइड एंड ketones. So first step, that is the oxidation of primary and secondary alcohols by using PCC. So PCC is a strong oxidizing agent which is actually known as pyridinium chlorochromate. So this is one is in a structure of pyridinium chlorochromate which is actually synthesized by using or by reaction of pyridine, hydrochloric acid and chromium trioxide. Okay, so we get a orange colored solid. Okay, and that solid is called as a PCC, pyridinium chlorochromate, which is generally used for the oxidation purpose. Okay, so that particular PCC is used to convert primary alcohols into an aldehyde and secondary alcohols into an ketone. So this is a special oxidizing agent which is used to convert primary and secondary alcohols, okay, into an aldehyde and ketones. So this is a reaction. So in this case, this is a primary alcohol. So as we know, why this is called as a primary alcohol, because only one R group is present, okay, that's why it is called as a primary alcohol. So generally structure of primary alcohol, that is R, C, OH, H and H. Okay, so only one alkyl group is present with CH2OH, that's why it is called as a primary alcohol. So in a simple language we say that when one alkyl group is attached to carbon and OH, carbon along with OH, so it is called as a primary alcohol. If you replace one of the hydrogen by a second alkyl group, so this is called as a secondary alcohol. And if you replace that is third hydrogen by R group, so it is called as a tertiary. So very simple, primary, we easily understand primary, secondary and tertiary alcohol by this concept. So PCC is generally used to convert primary alcohol into an aldehyde and secondary alcohol into an ketone. Okay, then these are the general examples of this primary and secondary alcohol. So how can we understand that particular part? So this CH2 group, okay, generally get converted into C double bond OH, or we say that CHOH group get converted into C double bond O. So as you see that I have written CHOH get converted into C double bond O. Okay, so this is a general trick. Two hydrogens get replaced, that's why it is called as an oxidation. So PCC is a strong oxidizing agent, selective oxidizing agent, which is used to prepare aldehyde and ketone. So this is in a first method. Then second method that we have to see, that is the Rosenmeier reduction reaction. So generally Rosenmeier reduction reaction is used in case of aryl halides. Okay, aryl halides, these are the compounds, that is AR C double bond OCl. So this is called as an aryl halide or aryl chloride. So generally chlorine is present, that's why it is called as an aryl halide. Okay, chloride. So generally aryl chlorides, when reacts with an hydrogen gas in presence of a palladium catalyst and co-catalyst, that is a barium sulfate and sulfur. So barium sulfate and sulfurs are used as a poisons. Okay, these actually not just the general word is used as a poison, but actually they control the reaction. What actually they control? So aryl halide, when reacts with an hydrogen gas in presence of these reagent, we get aldehyde as compound. So in this case, this Cl get replaced by hydrogen atom. Simple. Okay, so aryl halides get converted into aromatic aldehydes by using this. But if we cannot add this barium sulfate along with sulfur, so this aldehyde again reduce into an alcohol. So to control that reaction, Okay, so to control that reaction, we add poison in that reaction. So barium sulfate and sulfur prevent the further reduction of an aldehyde into an alcohol. So that's why Rosenmund reduction is a controlled reaction which is generally used to convert alloyl halides into an aldehyde. So I have written the simple trick, that is a COCl get converted to COH. I have written just understand this part, that Cl get replaced by H. That's why it is called an aldehyde. Then these are the examples of Rosenmund reduction reaction. So benzoic acid when reacts with a thionyl chloride, we get benzoyl chloride as a product. When we Rosenmund reduction reaction takes place on this compound, we get benzaldehyde. So for the preparation or synthesis of benzaldehyde, we use this Rosenmund reduction reaction. This then next example, again just substituted aromatic ring is there, but reaction takes place at that COCl, so COCl get converted to CHO. So just remember this thing, that in Rosenmund reduction reaction, COCl group get converted to CHO. Okay, so this is the most preferable method used for preparation of aldehyde and ketones, or generally aldehyde. Then next method, that is the hydration of alkynes. Hydration of alkynes means addition of water to alkyne. Okay, so when we take an alkyne and along with a catalyst, water get added, we get aldehyde or ketone as a product. That particularly depends on what type of substituents are attached to an alkyne. Okay, so this is reaction of, that is a hydration of alkyne. So generally catalyst used, that is a mercuric sulfate and sulfuric acid. So when alkyne reacts with water in presence of HgSO4, that is a mercuric sulfate along with H2SO4, we get enol form as a product, which on tautomerization gives aldehyde or ketone as a product. So this is an enol keto form. Okay, so this is most preferable method used to convert alkynes into aldehyde or ketones. So I have written this part, that is simple trick, C triple bond C get converted into aldehyde or ketone. So in this case, C triple bond C is there, okay, where one of the oxygen is attached to carbon and two hydrogens get attached to that another carbon. That's why we say that aldehyde and ketones are easily formed or prepared by using this reaction. Then there are some examples, again acetylene, if we take acetylene and water get added into that along with mercuric sulfate and H2SO4, enol form is formed, which get converted into keto form, and the product is acetaldehyde. So acetaldehyde is prepared from acetylene. Then this one is propene, prop1 in. Okay, again we get acetone as a product from this reaction. So generally alkynes get converted into aldehyde and ketones by using this particular reaction. Then next, that is the action of Grignard reagent on esters. So Grignard reagent reacts with an ester to give aldehyde and ketone as a product. Okay, but that aldehyde again reacts with another mole of a Grignard reagent to give a secondary alcohol as a product. So when esters react with a Grignard reagent, reaction is uncontrolled. So we cannot use this reaction for preparation of aldehyde and ketones, but side products are there. That is, aldehyde is formed, but when excess of Grignard reagent get added, that aldehyde readily get converted into an alcohol. Okay, that's why it is an uncontrolled reaction. We use that reaction for a theory purpose, but that does not give any type of pure product. Always there is impurities are present in our reaction. Okay, so other esters give tertiary alcohol. Generally formic ester gives aldehyde, then aldehyde again get converted to secondary alcohol, and other esters gives tertiary alcohol as a product. Okay, then next reaction, next preparation, that is the Guttermann-Koch formulation reaction. So what is the Guttermann-Koch formulation reaction? When benzene ring reacts with a carbon monoxide and hydrochloric acid in presence of an aluminium trichloride, we get benzaldehyde as a product. So this overall reaction is called as Guttermann-Koch formulation reaction, because this reaction is formulated by two scientists, that is Guttermann and Koch. That's why this is a named reaction. So this particular reaction is used to convert benzene into an aldehyde and ketone. Somehow we say that this is a greener reaction. Why? Because carbon monoxide is consumed and get converted into a product. Okay, that's why it is a greener type of a reaction. So when a benzene ring reacts with a carbon monoxide and hydrochloric acid in presence of an AlCl3, and to control that reaction, small amount of co-catalyst copper chloride is also added. Okay, and we get benzaldehyde as a product. So this is called as a Guttermann-Koch formulation reaction. So what is the mechanism behind that Guttermann-Koch formulation reaction? So in the first case, that this carbon monoxide and hydrochloric acid react together, okay, and form formyl chloride as a product. So we say that only HC double bond of carbon monoxide is added into between hydrogen and Cl. So we say that carbonyl group is added in between hydrogen and chlorine. So that's why formyl chloride is formed in a first step. That formyl chloride reacts with our catalyst. Okay, that catalyst absorbs one of the chlorine atom, get attached, and we get electron deficient species, that is formyl cation. So why it is called as a formyl cation? Because chlorine get replaced and we get H carbon with positive charge. So we already know that carbon with positive charge means cation and carbon with negative charge means anion. Okay, so positively charged species, electron deficient species, is called as an electrophile. So Guttermann-Koch formulation is an electrophilic substitution reaction. Okay, so electrophile generated in this reaction, that is in a formyl cation, which is also stabilized by electron donation of this oxygen atom and get converted into, so carbocation gets stabilized by electron donation, extra electrons are present or oxygens which are donated, so we get oxycation as a product, which is called as an acylation. So in first step formyl chloride is formed, and in a second step that formyl chloride get converted into an electrophile, that is the formyl cation. That formyl cation, okay, so electrophilic substitution reaction takes place in a third step. So electron rich aromatic ring attacks on the electron deficient carbon and we get cation. This one is an aromatic cation, which is unstable. We already know that aromatic cations are unstable. So the AlCl4- that is formed in a second step, absorbs this hydrogen atom and electron again migrates towards, and we get a stable aromatic compound, that is an aldehyde. So this is a four-step reaction, Guttermann-Koch formulation reaction, greener reaction is that. And in this case, this is a four-step reaction. First, carbon monoxide and hydrochloric acid reacts to give formyl chloride as a product. AlCl3 catalyst absorbs that chlorine and get converted into an AlCl4- and we get formyl cation as our electrophile. That formyl cation reacts with our benzene ring, which is we added into that. We get unstable cation, aromatic cation. Okay, so hydrogen get absorbed by AlCl4- or any other nucleophile, and we get our product, that is a benzaldehyde. So Guttermann-Koch formulation reaction, in this reaction formyl group is added into a reaction or substituted in this reaction, that's why it is called as a Guttermann-Koch formulation reaction. Then last reaction in our today's video, that is Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction. So Friedel-Crafts, so these are the scientists which discovered that reaction. Okay, what is the reaction? That is acylation. So acyl means, that is a C double bond O R group. R means any alkyl or aryl group. So acyl group get introduced into an arenes, means aromatic compound. So Friedel-Crafts discover a reaction where substitution of an acyl group takes place into a benzene ring. That's why it is called as a Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction. And this reaction happens in aromatic compounds. That's why it is called as a Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction. So introduction of acyl group into a benzene ring is called as a Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction. So what is the Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction? When a benzene treated with an acid halide or acetic anhydride in presence of in the same anhydrous AlCl3, that which we already used in a Guttermann-Koch formulation reaction, that is again used as a catalyst in the same reaction, we get our aldehyde or ketone as a product. So benzene reacts with acid chloride in presence of AlCl3. So this R C double bond O group get introduced in this reaction. So that's why it is called an acyl reaction. If we replace that acyl chloride by another reagent, that is acetic anhydride, again same reaction happens. Okay, and C double bond OR group get introduced into a reaction. That's why it is called as a Friedel-Crafts acylation of an arenes. So what is the mechanism behind that? So mechanism is same as Guttermann-Koch formulation reaction. Just first step get replaced. Okay, other steps are remain same. So directly we use any type of an acyl chloride or acetic anhydride in this case. So catalyst reacts with it and we get carbocation as our electrophile. That electrophile again reacts with a benzene ring to give cation as a product, same as a Guttermann-Koch formulation reaction. And AlCl4- which is form nucleophile abstract this proton, bond migration takes place and we get acylated aromatic compound as a product. So Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction is same as Guttermann-Koch reaction. Okay, but Guttermann-Koch formulation we use carbon monoxide and HCl as a starting reactant, but in this case we directly use acyl chloride or acetic anhydride as a reagent. So this is all about the today's video. Thank you.